Funding provided by...
You work hard to feed them well. That's why at Fairway, we're committed to our foundation of personalized service while treating our customers like family and valuing our employees. Fairway Meat and Grocery, that's what we're all about.
By Muskell Lighting, the sports lighting specialists, providing lighting systems for you, your project, and your community.
Small businesses are the backbone of Iowa's communities, and they are backed by Iowa banks. With advice, loans, and financial services, banks across Iowa are committed to showing small businesses the way to a stronger tomorrow. Learn more at iowabankers.com.
To downtown Des Moines as we kick off a triple header of Iowa girls high school hoops from inside the confines of Wells Fargo Arena. We crowned two champions last night. There are three titles yet to be decided, and you're going to watch them all on Iowa PBS. Hello, everybody. I'm Paul Yeager. Thanks for joining us here for our second night of live girls basketball tournament coverage. Iowa PBS Sports will continue to bring you the highlights and features from right here from the sports desk overlooking all the action. But first, let's go courtside. Here's BJ Shaben and Laura Leonard for their call of the 4A State Championship.
Thank you, Paul. It is time for state championship basketball, the Class 4A title game, as you've got Cedar Rapids Xavier seated fourth, taking on the number three seed, Bishop Heelan Crusaders. Hi again, everyone, with Laura Leonard. This is BJ Shaben and Laura, two teams that many didn't expect to be in this game today.
Yeah, and you know what? They say defense wins championships. Both of these teams got here with their defense, but I'll tell you, there's a couple of exciting players to watch on both of these teams, Brooklyn Stanley and Libby Fandell.
Well, let's take a look at their resumes. Xavier, quite impressive. Look out for their freshman, Libby Fandell. And of course, their team motto, together, no regrets. On the other side, for Bishop Heelan, this is a team that is going to go for their fourth basketball title. 50th year of Crusader basketball. They're a sister act, too, as well. And look out for their sensational sophomore in Brooklyn Stanley. Let's go to Tim Fitzpatrick, our public address announcer.
Gentlemen, it's time to meet the teams for this 4A championship.
Xavier fans, let's hear it for your Saints.
Bishop Heelan fans, let's hear it for your Crusaders.
Fans, it's now time to introduce the players in today's 4A championship matchup. First, the non-starters, the visiting team from Cedar Rapids, the Xavier Saints. Number zero, Emma Arnold. Number two, Riley Yonker. Number four, Sydney Huber. Number five, Ava Turner. Number 11, Allie Shookman. Number 21, Kyla Mason. Number 22, Taylor Rexroth. Number 24, Lexi Turner. And number 35, Aaliyah Beyer. Your assistant coaches, Stephanie Potts, Beth Semick, Jim Potts, and Liam McConville. And now, here are your non-starters for the home team from Sioux City, the Bishop Heelan Crusaders. Number 3, Addison Keel. Number 13, Peyton Schermerhorn. Number 23, Jada Newberg. Number 25, Sophia Kuntz. Number 31, Lauren LaFleur. Number 33, Julie Verzel. Number 41, Kiki Demke. Number 43, Carly Kolb. And number 45, Abby Lee. Your assistant coaches, Jeff Donaldson, Jessica Carson, Sean Miller, and Olivia Solentic. And now, let's meet your starters in this 4A championship. From Xavier at forward, a 5'11 senior, number 10, Maya Carl. For Bishop Heelan at guard, a 5'3 sophomore, number 1, Maddie Demke. At guard for Xavier, a 6-foot freshman, number 13, Libby Fandel. At guard for the Crusaders, a 5'8 junior, number 5, Lauren Peck. For Xavier at guard, a 5'8 senior, number 15, Lexi Beyer. For Bishop Heelan at guard, a 5'8 sophomore, number 11, Brooklyn Stanley. For the Saints at forward, a 5'10 senior, number 20, Maddie Steger. For the Crusaders at guard, a 5'9 junior, number 15, Kenley Meese. And for Xavier at forward, a 5'7 senior, number 30, Mary Kate Mader. For Bishop Heelan at forward, a 5'9 senior, number 21, Jocelyn Verzel. Head coach for the Saints, Tom Lilly. For the Crusaders, Darren Koolstra. Now, ladies and gentlemen, turn your attention to the area in front of the scorers table. Your officials assigned to this 4A championship by the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union. Ben Applegate, Tim Osterhaus, Bryant Abel, and the bench official, Jared Ray. All right, who's ready for state championship basketball?
We sure hope you are on Iowa PBS. Or what are the keys to the game? First up for Xavier.
Well, they need to get quality perimeter shots. They have to work the ball around the defense and try to find the weak spots in the zone, get good looks, and then take what the defense gives them. If they're giving them that short corner, go ahead and take that. Don't have to try to jam it into the middle. And then for Heelan, they need to go defense to offense, get that defense to create turnovers, get some points off of it, and execute the game plan, especially at the end of quarters. That helps give them momentum.
The Crusaders, Bishop Heelan wearing their home white Xavier and their dark navy. We are ready to go. They've battled their way to the 4A title game, and it's now underway with the tip-off being controlled by Xavier. This is a team with some impressive wins to get here. As you see who's on the floor with Carl, Fandel, Beyer, Steiger, and Mader. Here's a three from the outside, and Mary Kate Mader gets it going.
Yeah, that's exactly what they need to do, is just wait, move the ball around, see if they can find some gaps in this 1-3-1.
The Crusaders will attack with Demke, and it will be turned over. Xavier has been a team that has been just, reckless defensively, just causing all sorts of havoc against their opponents. And, of course, knocked out DCG in a very memorable semifinal game, as it went to overtime three times before the victor was determined.
You can see that defense collapse down low as it goes in to the bottom part and in the block area. That's where you can collapse down defensively. Then you're going to have to look out and see if you can find somebody open.
They hit it inside the paint to Steger. Back out to the freshman, Bando. And Xavier, the Saints will reset, coming into the game at 19-6 overall. First state tournament appearance in 2 years. And of course, going for their fifth title. This jumper off the mark, and the Crusaders come down with a rebound. They look to attack. Means can't get it. And the rebound to Byer.
Look how quickly they get down the floor as soon as they get that rebound, transition down the floor. Didn't really have the numbers, but decided that she was going to take it at the defense anyway.
Vandell with the quick dump, and that's swatted out of bounds by Jocelyn Berzel.
You know, against this zone, some ball fakes help that will get them out of position. They are anticipating, they're reading the eyes. Can't telegraph anything, but if you give a really good ball fake, you're gonna get the defenders out of position and be able to create shots.
Boy, they're summing up the zone, the three ball. Can't get it to fall. Carl's put back, no. Mater. And Xavier really owning the offensive rebounds there, but it's going to go to the Crusaders.
They've been doing a really good job on the glass. And again, the 1-3-1, you have one person down underneath the basket, hoping that those wing players will come down and help you. But that leaves some rebounding opportunities down low for Xavier.
Crusaders on the floor with Demke, Peck, Stanley, Meese, and Berzel. They'll reset here with Demke, the sophomore. This is Stanley.
Stanley has had a really great tournament so far. 23 points in the first game, 16 in the second. And they need to find a way to slow her down, but she has been carving up defenses all tournament long.
The trap in the corner, here's Byer. She'll set up and hit.
Averaging seven, almost 8 points a game, and 65% of her shots come from the three-point line. The defense needs to be aware of where she is and make sure they're getting out there cautiously and getting a hand in the face.
This press by Xavier has been effective all tournament long. Here's a three, the match not there. Rebound by Berzel, can't get the put back, and the freshman Fandel up with it.
A lot of offensive rebounds to be had on both ends, and both teams having a hard time connecting on those second chance points.
Now to the outside, that's Mater. Hitting Painter. It's a 9-2 lead for Xavier.
And we talked about in the keys, what do they need to do? Get quality perimeter shots. That's what they're doing so far.
And a tough shot that time by Stanley. This one gonna be poked in backcourt and now stolen away by Stanley. Finds the teammate, and the layup is there for Berzel.
You know, it's just a situation where Fandel wasn't sure if she should pick that up, if it was going to be over and back, but it was touched back that way. She could have picked it up, but just a little indecision, you don't ever know. And they were able to get the steal and the 2 points.
Boy, the tide has really turned on Heelan and their semifinal win against Glenwood. They came out and they hit all the threes early on to build the lead. This is Byer.
And something that may not be a part of their game plan each and every game, but boy, they were on fire in that semifinal game.
A complete line change coming up.
And you can see here's a good look against that zone. Ball movement, moving without the basketball. Byer hits one. Then about the same spot, they get another one from Mater. They're going to have to rely on that here and see if they can shoot them out of that zone.
So Xavier with five fresh bodies out on the floor with Lexi Turner, Kyla Mason, Emma Arnold, Riley Yonker, and Sydney Huber. And also going to their bench was the Crusaders as Jada Newberg checks into the contest along with Lauren LaFleur, and this is gonna be turned over.
Reminds me a little bit of what Newell Fonda does defensively in a different way. All the pressure's in the front court, and we're going to get a timeout because I think there needs to be some adjustments made by Bishop Heelan.
Darren Koolstra takes the timeout. Each coach is mic'd up here throughout the state championship day. Let's listen in on the Xavier Saints with head coach Tom Lilly.
Know where she's at. We're in Sugar Pop. You're running baseline. You're in the middle. Okay, but when we everybody good with where we're supposed to go? Okay, pass to a wing, fade, middle pops. Come on, let's not panic now. Let's go. Saints, 1, 2, 3, Saints.
That is Tom Lilly. 37 years he's been a head coach, 24 seasons at Xavier Laura, 597 victories.
And he has kind of been through the gauntlet. He's seen the good and the bad, and he said, however, never in my time have I been in a three overtime game, and that's what they were in, and able to win and get to this title game.
Said he was having almost like, felt like he had a panic attack in that triple overtime win against Dallas Center Grimes. So here we go with Arnold. That jumper left short of the rebound, comes down to LaFleur. Let's see if Heelan gained some composure back, rushed a few shots early on. Demke trying to get it to the post to LaFleur and does. Now the kick out. And going to the line, and she's going to have to earn them, is Kennelly Mees, the junior.
And it was good inside-out basketball as LaFleur got the ball in the middle, turned and looked, saw she had the defender on her, kicked it back outside. And that allows Mees to get to the free throw line.
Yonker picked up the foul. That's her first. Mees, a 66% free throw shooter. In fact, you know, she made it known to us, Laura, did Kennelly, that felt like they were really burned here over the last couple of trips here to the state tournament. And coming up short last year, not making it. And really wanted to make their way back. And boy, have they did well getting here to the title game. It's a 4-point contest. Xavier back with the ball.
And those are little things that you kind of just put in your back pocket and you remember and you think about when you're setting goals at the beginning of the season. What are the things that are going to motivate you? And that obviously was one thing that motivated this team.
Addison Keel into the contest here for the Crusaders. Just checked in at the last dead ball. And it looks like another line change here coming up for the Xavier Saints at the next dead ball. Inside it goes to LaFleur, who tried to hit a cutter to the hoop and Newberg, and it's going to stay with the Crusaders. So let's check this out. It's the starting five back in here for Xavier and Beyer, Mader, Carl, Steger, and Fandel. It's like a hockey line change here, Laura.
Well, that's exactly what it is. It looks like he's got two sets of five that he interchanges, puts them in, keeps fresh legs out there because they are going to keep the full court pressure on you the entire ball game.
Well, Demke hits the deck hard and will go to the line.
This is a good take and a very determined drive by Demke to get right inside, and they've tried to navigate along that side multiple times, but the defense has moved around. This time she took it right at him and drew the contact.
Fandel picks up the foul, and Demke able to knock down the free throw. Starting to whittle away against this lead. At one point it was at 9-2.
They've been getting to the free throw line, so changing strategy a little bit. They're being a little more aggressive, trying to get inside and draw some contact.
Lauren Peck will come back into the game as that free throw is sank.
Now a little pressure of their own.
Going to be tied up. Possession arrow. We'll give it to the Crusaders. So it's about as close as we could get to a West Coast, to a team out east, as we could get further apart. These two perennial powers ready to do battle here in the state championship. And what a quarter it's been here so far. 9-7. Heelan down but with the ball. There's Newberg. And she'll tie it up.
A couple of times, and Coach Lilly doesn't like what he's seen. He wants to talk to his team because last couple of times down the floor, they're setting that high screen, getting that drive to the right side, and the defense isn't adjusting.
Let's go to the Heelan huddle.
Talk to you and talk about that air time. Go Lauren one time.
Here we go. Listen up. We're 33. We can get steals on air time. All right, air time. Go for that. They're throwing some really high lob passes. You're on a wing. Take a chance. All right, let's go. Good comeback. Let's
hey, go. We're going slice down there. You can go either way now. One, two, three.
Last voice you heard was the head coach, Darren Koolstra, 12 years at Heelan, took a year off, and now back into the helm, missed basketball quite a bit. And you know what? I tell you what, you don't get this type of coverage anywhere except here on Iowa PBS, where the coaches are mic'd up. And they've all been gracious enough to put the microphone on, leave it on, and give us some insight throughout the game. You'll see and hear that throughout all of our championships here today. This layup is put down by Maya Carl.
Good execution that time out of the timeout to get a bucket and try to get things back to where you want it to be when you started this quarter.
That's the second field goal of the tournament for Maya Carl. This will stay in bounds to Demke.
You know, you just saw the length of Libby Fandel and what she can do on the top and that pressure. She's got the long arms that can get out in the passing lanes, create problems for the passers.
Nader over to Byer.
They're willing to wait as the clock winds down.
The zone creates the turnover. 20 seconds to play in the quarter, looking to attack. Newberg.
Wow, what a nice move. Just a quick step through. Brought that ball right over the top, but Brenna Demke, she was the one that was pointing at her and said, get down there, I'm gonna get you the basketball.
There we go, Mater at the horn. And through one quarter, we are tied at 11. Let's go to Paul Yeager, who's standing by.
Thank you, BJ. Thank you very much, Laura. Good first quarter, ends even, but here's how they ended up in the title game. Let's take a look at their semifinal highlights real quick as we start. DCG and Xavier, they needed three overtimes for this one. Libby Fandel, who's been held scoreless in this quarter, and Kyla Mason, and then Fandel again hits that winning, what ended up being the go-ahead bucket in triple overtime, as Xavier survived by five. Bishop Heelan, well, they needed to take care of business with Glenwood, and the Rams were the higher seed in this game, so the Crusaders, they get Jaden Newberg, then Lauren Peck, Kenley Meese, and Peck again for the three. Heelan held off a couple of charges by Glenwood to move on to tonight's final. Let's go back down to the floor. BJ Shaven and Laura Leonard.
Thank you, Paul. Let's go to Tim Fitzpatrick for the introduction to this year's Class 4A
Fans,
Iowa Bankers
year,
Award
basketball
winner.
Tournament, the Iowa Bankers Association presents the Student Athlete Achievement Award to a student athlete who excels on the court, in the classroom, and in her community. The recipient receives a $1,000 scholarship to the college of her choice. The 2022 Student Athlete Achievement Award winner is Kaylin Petrock from Dallas Center Grimes High School. Presenting the 2022 award is Nick Reggio from Charter Bank in Grimes. Congratulations to Kaylin, and thank you to Nick Reggio with Charter Bank and the Iowa Bankers Association for their sponsorship of this award and continued support of the IGHSAU.
We are tied at 11 as we head into the second quarter of play. Heelan in the semis attack with a three. Now they're just going right at the hoop.
Look at that move. That was one that Newberg was not going to be denied, but all set up by Maddie Demke, who is leading the charge, directing traffic out there. Xavier with five turnovers here in the first quarter, and Heelan able to score 8 points off those turnovers, and that happened right in the middle part of the first quarter after Xavier got off to a good start.
Xavier with a little bit of a different lineup out on the floor. You've got Byer, Mater, Carl, Steger, and also Kyla Mason, who leads the team in scoring. She comes off the bench. This is her second appearance, averaging nearly 10 points per game. Xavier with five players who average over 5 points per contest, which is a pretty balanced attack.
It really is, and any one of those players could have a big night for their team. It's not just one player focus as far as the scoring goes. Everybody distributes the basketball. Everybody has a hand in the scoring column.
Heelan with another steal. They actually set the school record for steals this season, which was pretty meaningful on the 50th anniversary of Heelan girls basketball. It's something that they talked about at the beginning of the season, Laura, and by golly, they got it.
They did, and that was something, you know, you set those goals and you're able to accomplish them, and starting now to heat up from the outside.
How about Jocelyn Berzel knocking it down, scoreless at the state tournament coming into today's game, now with 5 points in the contest. 14-11, Heelan with the lead now.
And Berzel, the only senior on this Bishop Heelan team. They're gonna be back, they're loaded, and they've made the run so far this season. They've got a lot of players coming back.
That one in and out, it's gonna stay with Xavier. And Vendell will come back into the game. She will replace Lexi Byer. Able to hit the middle of the paint, not there. The putback by Carl, no good, but we'll go to the line to shoot two. Maya Carl has been a force here in this game inside.
They have done a really good job getting to that offensive glass and getting themselves into position, but have not been able to score off of those. Xavier with three offensive rebounds, feels like it's been a lot more than that.
Last foul on Demke, her first. And the first Heelan foul of the game. With Laura Leonard, I'm BJ Shaven here on Iowa PBS. It's the Class 4A state championship game. The Heelan Crusaders out of Sioux City taking on the Cedar Rapids Xavier Saints. And this is going to be tied up. It'll go to the Crusaders. And coming back into the game, Riley Yonker will come back in for Maya Carl here. Crusaders sticking with their lineup of Demke, Peck, Stanley, Mies, and LaFleur now. And a steal by Turner.
Great read and good anticipation. Just going up like a defensive back in football, just getting in to the passing lane and pulling that away.
And going to the line here is going to be Riley Yonker. The 6 foot senior able to get that rebound and draw contact.
Both of these teams have a lot of multi-sport athletes, and Yonker is a player that was on the volleyball team that went to state. So not only do you have the experience of being here at the state basketball tournament, you've got some players that have experienced state tournament pressure in other sports.
That's the first bench point right there by Yonker, and now the second. And that's where Xavier's really been strong all season long, especially they haven't lost since late January. And now a 5 second call is gonna be called on Heelan.
Yep. Defensive pressure really locked down that time, and LaFleur just was roaming the baseline trying to find somebody.
And the Crusaders with the steal out ahead. Knees to the corner, and stepping on the sideline was Newberg.
And they're both playing at a very high pace and a high tempo. And both teams turning it over a little bit, and you've got to slow it down, get some things going, and get into a rhythm just like that. That's a great feed from the high post inside and a really good strong power move.
Yonker now with four. And Xavier back out in front. And rebound tipped out, LaFleur up with it.
Good battle inside, and LaFleur got great inside position to be able to keep that rebound in their possession.
Stanley with a reverse, not there. LaFleur can't get it.
Just a little off balance with that shot and that put back.
Now the three ball. And it's gonna go to Bishop Heelan. Xavier again substituting here quite frequently as Byer will come back into the game. She'll be in for Turner. Again, there's the pressure to greet you. And the Crusaders look to break. Here's Newberg out ahead to LeFleur, couldn't handle the pass. Now the trap. And a foul going to be called on Yonker.
Just relentless. As soon as LeFleur picked up that ball, double team came, and it was aggressive. Obviously, got called for the foul, but you have to secure that basketball right away and then protect it.
Berzel will come back into the game. She's in for LeFleur. Xavier also to their bench now, as Steger is in for Yonker. And also back in is Carl, who will come in for Mason. Laura, why is the press here at the state tournament? Some teams can, I mean, they play full court pressure all season long. It seems like in years past, they've been able to get to the state tournament. The bigger floor has caused problems. For Xavier, it's not an issue. Why?
Because I think they're so quick at every position. I think they can recover even though it's a bigger floor. I think if they gamble, they are so quick, they can get back and then they help one another. They can get into position and switch up.
Berzel with that three puts her team back up by two. Heelan looking to add to it. Demke to the rack.
That's twice we have seen a move of sweeping the ball past the defender as the defender flies by. And first it was Newberg, and then this time it was Demke.
And Demke, great hustle that time by Mies to keep it alive. Heelan starting to roll, their largest lead of the game. And now a turnover.
Just got a little ahead of herself. Good crossover dribble and then the kick out to the open shooter. And then what about that move? That is just under control, getting the ball away from the defender and finishing strong.
Heel back into the game for Heelan. Xavier goes to their bench. Mater into the contest with the ball right now. And a timeout going to be taken here by Xavier. 30-second timeout. Let's go to the Xavier huddle.
We're changing the offense. Take a breather and relax, okay? And we'll let you know, all right? This is the reason why we're playing. We're like way over excited right now. Settle down, all of you. Settle, defend, okay? We're in Sugar Pop. Hey, dribble, entry, screen.
Who's guarding 21? Okay, so she's hit two threes. So you gotta get on.
Here we go, Saints. One, two, three, Saints.
That's Tom Lilly, longtime coach. And of course, you notice he's got a new tie today, Laura. After the semifinal win against Dallas Center Grimes, he got doused with water. And he says his wife always does a great job of picking out ties for him. He's not superstitious about him, but ready to go. But what do you think about the message? Settle down.
I totally agree with it. They've just kind of gotten away from the game plan, and they are playing maybe a little tight, a little overexcited, and they need to go back to run the offense. You heard him say dribble, entry, and then curl, and there they got it.
Can't get the bucket as Heelan comes down with the ball.
And that's an example of being overexcited, rushing the shot. You got a great open look at it, gather yourself, go up strong, and that's what Coach Lilly's talking about. You just need to take a breath.
Here's Demke. Knees back outside again to Keel. Now the dump down to Demke. You know, sometimes you think, okay, a player hasn't scored. Berzel didn't score here at the state tournament until today in the championship game, and she has eight. As you see this drive, not there. So it wasn't a part of the game plan to leave somebody open. We just heard that in the huddle.
Yeah, and you could say, okay, or you heard, say, who's on 21? She's hit two threes. You have to go out, and you have to respect that now because she has knocked down a couple of them, but you have to go out cautiously, under control. Don't let her drive by you.
Trying to avoid the trap is Byer. Now we'll dribble out of it to reset.
And that's where the strong points are of this zone, right on the base, or excuse me, on the sidelines. you got that point player coming down and then the wing player coming up to trap. And you know that when you get trapped, somebody's gonna be open, but you've gotta be able to step through that and find somebody.
Demke gonna be fouled on the play by Mader. And for Mader, that will be her first, the team's third against Xavier. Each team coming in with three new fresh players. As you take a look at the collision here.
Mader wasn't gonna let her make any kind of a move to get back to the middle. Tried to come in from the backside and strip her of the basketball, and a lot of bodies in the same spot at one time.
Heelan coming into the game with Peyton Schirmerhorn, the junior, with her first action of the afternoon. Also back in is Berzel. And Stanley. With the ball now is Peck, tries to enter it. Great pass and finished by Stanley. What a dime.
What a perfect pass, threading the needle. That's something that you've practiced all season long, communication with the eyes, and just running the play and executing.
Let's take a look at this again.
This is so good and so sweet, and Lauren Peck just leaves it in the right spot and the right place, and Brooklyn Stanley able to get to the glass. That is as well as you can run a play like that.
Lauren Peck picked up the foul, back to the line here again with Riley Yonker. And Fandel will come back into the game for Xavier.
You know, Lauren Peck is a player in the semifinal game. She was 4 of 7 from three-point range. Knowing that, you're gonna have to guard her a little bit more closely. That gives her a little bit more room to drop off passes and set up teammates.
Yonker now with 6 to lead the Saints. Heelan able to break it. Stanley, now the 3. Schirmerhorn couldn't get that to go down. Now here come the Saints leading the break. Rebound! And it's 1 and done as the rebound comes down to Peck.
You know, that's a situation where I'd like to see somebody pull up and shoot that mid-range jumper. You don't need to take it all the way in. Defense is retreating. Go ahead and pull up and knock down the short jumper.
Mees knocks down her first triple of the game. And it's to a 7-point lead. Crusaders, their largest lead.
They're starting to extend this defense out a little bit further, making Xavier start the offense further away from the basket.
And this is gonna be a foul on Xavier on the rebound, as Mees had great clearance. That foul on Huber. That's the 5th team foul here on Xavier. So the Saints back to their bench. They're looking for some offense. Kyla Mason will come back in. And Maya Carl also back into the contest.
Mason has been fairly quiet here in this ball game, and she's a player that has had 2 really good games.
Maddie Demke back into the game with the ball right now. We'll slow it down. Heelan gonna hold for 1 here with a 7-point advantage, their largest of the game. It's been a huge second quarter here. They've scored 13 and have held Xavier to 6.
And this is where they want to execute at the end of the quarter. Coach Koolstra said this is something they've practiced all season long, executing at the end of a quarter to give you momentum.
Xavier with an opportunity. Fandel just off the mark. 24-17, Heelan with the lead on Xavier. As we are at the half. As let's go to Paul Yeager, who's standing by.
All right, thank you very much, BJ and Laura. As they take a break, we get going with our halftime, and that's gonna begin with a number of things, and that includes our halftime conversation with the coach that's leading. Let's start with Darren Koolstra from Bishop Heelan. Coach, watching the second quarter, that was a different team than you had in the first quarter. What the aggressiveness on defense, it wasn't transition that made a big difference on offense, but what did the defense do to help your team?
Well, we just recognize what they're doing, trying to beat our 1-3-1. We're getting in passing lanes a little bit better, anticipation. Our middle girls get into the low block a lot quicker than we were. We got to continue to apply the pressure, get more rebounds, obviously, and get the ball out and go.
You got a balanced scoring as well. Only one player is out with eight. So is that also key for you?
It is key. They play unselfish. They have all year. They're just going to continue to do that, feed on each other, and they trust their teammates. That's a positive thing.
All right, Coach, thank you so very much. Appreciate the time.
You bet. Thank you.
It's Darren Koolstra, head coach for Bishop Heelan. As we continue with our halftime, we go to the tradition of the All-Iowa dance team.
The All-Iowa Honor Dance Team is making its 41st appearance at the Girls State Basketball Tournament. 92 high school dance teams are represented in this year's All-Iowa Honor Dance Team. Over 550 dancers auditioned at Newton High School last fall for the 224 positions. All schools are members of the Iowa State Dance Team Association. Choreographers are Jackie Aginaga, Betty Baker, Andrea Dana, Jackie Morse, and Stacy Horton. The director of the All-Iowa Honor Dance Team is Kathy Inyard. This performance is dedicated to Lois Turnage. Sit back and enjoy the greatest show in Iowa, the 2022 All-Iowa Honor Dance Team. the 2022 All-Iowa Honor Dance Team.
Excellent, as always. A reminder that all of the halftime pageantry, awards, and special features that are brought to you by your statewide television network, Iowa PBS. And you know what? We cannot do this extensive coverage without the support from viewers like you. So please take a moment to call, text, or go online and make a pledge right now. Your support ensures that we can continue this coverage for generations to come. A reminder that Iowa PBS is committed to telling the stories about young Iowans who are doing exceptional things by celebrating their success and sharing their journey through a digital series that we call In Their Words. Meet Annie Schlarman, who participated in the first ever Beyond Limits category at the Iowa State Dance Team Championships. And that gave an opportunity for dancers with disabilities to showcase their talents.
Hi, I'm Annie, and I'm from Monticello High School, and I'm a freshman. Let's go Panthers!
Sing along with me, sing along with me. You gotta know how to treat me like a lady. Even when I'm acting crazy, tell me everything's alright.
I have been dancing for the past 11 years.
Why did you want to start dance classes?
My older sisters were in dance and it looked really fun.
How do you feel when you dance?
I feel real happy and free.
And don't forget the flowers that bring the verse away.
The Iowa State Dance and Drill Team Association has been making accommodations for disabilities for performers within their teams for many years. And this year we expanded that to having a solo category specific to dancers with disabilities. Our new solo category was titled Beyond Limits. We had four dancers from four different teams across the state. And once we announced back in April of 2021 that we were having this category, I know those coaches and dancers got to work right away. These dancers and these students have super abilities, and we wanted to showcase that through this Beyond Limits category.
Gonna keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain.
Personally, for me, watching the Beyond Limits performers was emotional, inspiring, exciting. I was just blown away with their talent, their courage, and their ability to go out on this stage at State Dance and perform so proudly. I'm really excited to continue the Beyond Limits solo category. This year's performers have paved the way for future dancers.
So, Annie, how did you feel about performing at the state dance event?
It was really fun to share my love for dance.
How do you help other dancers?
I like to compliment my teammates and cheer them on.
What other activities do you enjoy?
For sports, I really like basketball and softball.
How much did you practice for your Beyond Limits performance?
I have practiced for a couple of times a week with my dance teacher and for many, many months. I remember when I received my award and everybody stood up for me. I felt really special and happy.
What do you want to do with dance in the future?
I want to help young girls become better dancers.
Better love me right.
I love dance.
In Their Words is provided by Musco Lighting and the Pella Roll Screen Foundation.
After an introduction by Princess Grace of Monaco, he took the stage.
I've got you under my skin.
And Frank Sinatra gave the London crowd a legendary show.
I did it my way.
The landmark 1970 performance. Sinatra in concert.
This evening at 9 on Iowa PBS.
PBS presents Broadway in Concert, an evening with Lerner and Lowe. Broadway and film hits My Fair Lady, Brigadoon, Gigi, Camelot, and many more were created by Alan J. Lerner and Frederick Lowe. Join us for an all-star musical salute with performances by Jen Colella, Aisha Jackson, Aaron Lazar, the American Pops Orchestra, and more.
Sunday afternoon at 5:30 on Iowa PBS.
Doesn't matter if it's at night or during the day, we still have to keep the floor quick clean. The tuxedo sweep taking place under the spotlights as they clean the logo and clean the floor after the All-Iowa Dance Team halftime. Bishop Heelan leads Xavier 24-17. Take a bow, guys. All right, thank you. We are going to, again, change this format just a little bit. A lot of times we feature lots of things, but we want to do some live conversations. Last night, you did get a chance to see Maddie Schultz. She's the E. Wayne Cooley Scholarship winner. Almost 100 girls applied for this one, and I hear this is one of the most ridiculously intense competitions there are. Anything more than your 11 letters have been at Woodbury Central. Why do you think you stood out to the committee?
I think most of it was just because I think of myself as very personable, so I think it was easy to connect with them and to talk to them about certain things that they're interested in. And I also told them at the end of the thing that I really didn't prepare for it, so they thought that was funny.
Oh, so that's funny. And I've noticed, I've seen you a lot this week. You've been laughing, good spirit about things. Is that just all part of it? A good sense of humor goes a long way. Is that how you feel?
Yeah. I'm definitely one of those people that, like, I laugh at everything, and so I have a contagious laugh just because it's kind of weird, so a lot of people tend to end up laughing after I laugh, so
it works. It sets the tone. All right, 11 different letters, softball, volleyball, golf, all conference honors in all three sports. So the sports is one thing. Tell me about some of your other activities than sports.
I'm vice president of our student council, and then I'm also in the yearbook, and I do speech, independent group, and then I'm in theater.
Okay, and you also have an official jacket on. You're also on a committee here with the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union.
Yes, I am.
What is that?
Basically, they choose certain girls out of the state to represent high school girls athletics, so we each represent different parts of the state.
And you've been here, part of the responsibility is to come to state tournaments?
Yep.
And so what did you do this week for basketball?
This year we ran the social media page, so if you guys follow the IGHSAU,
yeah. I know it is.
If you guys follow that and you see all the posts, we're making those posts. And we also post the game turnouts, and we run some pages for people. We give out awards. It just kind of depends what day you're
Did
here.
You ever go on court to present any of the fan awards before the game during the quarters and semis?
I didn't present the, so we have the.
But the committee did.
Yes.
All right, Maddie, good luck to you at Iowa State next year.
Yep.
Good, congratulations. Thank you for the time.
Thank you.
All right, let's take a look at the halftime highlights. Thank you very much, Maddie. And we have a good 4A game. Let's take a look at what has happened. It has been a three show early on for Xavier. Mary Kate Mader. She had 6 points coming via the three. Lexi Beyer, that was her three. As Xavier early on was getting good ball movement and getting some open shots. They've gone a little bit cold later in the second quarter, mostly because of great plays like this for Heelan, Jocelyn Verzal. Now her three again. She had 8 points. That was the one outlier of everybody getting four that we talked about with Coach Koolstra before the break. And there's another big shot It is a impressive first half for both of these teams. We kind of expected a good one here. Joining us now is Xavier coach Tom Lilly. And coach, by the way, that is a nice tie, championship level tie. Way to go. All right, ball movement early was working. What's been a little more challenging in that second quarter?
Well, I think our kids are playing a little tight. I don't think that they expected to see how quick they were. I think that we weren't able to successfully, get much off of our press, and I think that kind of rattled our kids. I think they were expecting that every time we press, it's going to be beneficial.
How do you get a teenage girl to get unrattled?
Take a big deep breath and come out and play basketball like it's a simple game of basketball that we've played for a long, long time. We've got some seniors that have to play. We certainly expect Fandel and Kyla Mason to, show up in the second half and help us with that.
Yeah, Libby held scoreless. How are the legs? It looks like you've been running a lot of maybe 2 to 3 waves here, keeping everybody fresh.
Well, we weren't sure if they were going to be able to keep up or not, and we're going to find out what they got left in the second half of this game. Otherwise, sitting on a bench and with your better players is probably something that we're not going to do, and we'll see what they got left.
All right, Coach, I appreciate the time. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
All right, that's Tom Lilly, head coach of the Xavier Saints, and we go back down to the court now again as B.J. Chabon and Laura Leonard, they've rested for a moment, and it could be a very up-tempo second half, you two.
It sure could. As you take a look at the statistics here, Xavier just 5 of 21 from the field, 9 steals by Heelan. Those are the two stats that really stand out to you, right, Laura?
Yeah, and you know what? The turnovers as well. Xavier had 9 turnovers, and Heelan was able to score 13 points off of those turnovers. That's a biggie. And, the other one that kind of jumps out, and Coach alluded to that, was Fandel has not gotten off any shots. They have held her scoreless, and they have limited her touches. And Mason hasn't been able to get off. She only got off 1 shot. And so they're doing a great job of holding down their 2 main scorers.
Well, Jocelyn Brazal also, how about this? What a night. A senior in championship night in the first half. She set a career high with 8. Her season high was 5. What a half. Let's see what's in store here for the second as Heelan and Xavier are ready to do battle here on Iowa PBS. What an afternoon. It is the 4A state championship game. We've got the 2A title game coming your way here momentarily. Thank you, Hartford, the top seed, taking on Central Lyon. And then, of course, the nightcap in Class 1A. Tipping off at 7 o'clock tonight, it's Bishop Garrigan against Marcus Barrett and Claghorn Remsen Union.
Well done. Well done. That's a lot of consolidation there. But you know what? It's worked very well for them, the two programs combined. And here they are later tonight going to battle for a state title.
So out on the floor here for Xavier to begin the late half, it's Beyer, Mader, Carl, Steger, and Fandel. And for Heelan, it's Demke, Peck, Stanley, Mies, and Berzel. So here we go, the dump down. Underneath, it's going to be tipped around off of Carl's hands, and Heelan will come up with it. A turnover right away to begin the second half.
Yeah, good set play coming out to start the half, and they ran it well, with the exception of the recovery of the defense, got their hand in there, and so it's going to be there. They just need to run it a little bit quicker and recognize it sooner.
Mies on the dribble drive. Almost a turnover, now it is. The quick hands by Carl. Fandel out ahead, the 3 ball. Left short, and the rebound tipped down to Stanley. Now, Coach Lilly mentioned to Paul just a moment ago about the energy they might have. Is it a hangover from that 3 overtime game a couple of days ago?
And it could be. It could be that combined with battling under the bright lights and battling for a state title game and the adrenaline rush and the excitement. And I think that's all a big part of it when you have those tired legs. You got a quick timeout here that getting trapped, don't want to give up that possession.
Let's hear what head coach Darren Koolstra has to say.
Again, Brooklyn and Maddie, get a little lower. Okay? Get a little lower so we can get more room. Catching them.
Hey, how about 11?
Okay.
Run 11.
All right, you guys remember 11? Okay.
See if it's open.
Work, somebody has to get open.
Remember, you got to come towards the ball a little bit. Here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Let's go. We're running 11.
Well, you can hear him say, running 11. We're all going to find out what 11 is here to see if they can execute it as planned.
Darren Koolstra, 12 years at Heelan, has a couple of state championships back in 2010 and 2020. Of course, after 2020, stepped away and missed it so much. The AD, actually, at Sioux City Heelan, Jay Wright, was the girls' coach, then took the AD position. And Darren Koolstra said, hey, you're going to be AD, right? Yep. So he relieved his duties, and he said, I might know of a person who can coach your girls' basketball team. He goes, it's me. I want back. And boy, did he come back in a big way.
Yeah, he did. He said he knew what was in the pipeline, knew that the kids were hardworking and had a lot of big goals, wanting to get back to the state tournament. And he said he really did miss it, and he knew he was going to miss it when he stepped away, and back in the saddle and fighting for the championship.
And a charge gonna be called here on Fandel.
Boy, and that's just a good job of Stanley just holding her ground. She set the screen, stood there, and Fandel was just gonna fight her way through it and gets called for the charge.
That's her second. Here's Peck in the paint. And Xavier needs a bucket here, down by seven. Fandel, the three, got it!
Well, you ask and you receive. That's exactly what they needed, and great court vision. Fandel set up right at the three-point line, knocked down her first bucket of the ball game.
Crusaders surveying, now we'll drive. How about that? And one, as Mies will go to the line.
That is a really nice drive. A little jab step, sees the opening, goes up strong with the left hand, gets a little contact on the way up, but under enough control to get it to go through.
Steger will pick up her second. Crusaders go back to their bench. Jada Newberg into the game, along with Lauren LaFleur. And the Saints get the rebound. Out ahead, the lead pass can be deflected back in. Great athleticism that time by Newberg to save it in. It's gonna be tied up. Possession arrow will give it to Heelan.
Good things happen when you hustle, and Newberg was like she was in a track meet starting the 100-meter dash. She was just hustling from inline to inline and got a hand in the passing lane.
Heelan trying to break the pressure here, and it's kicked around. Who's it off of? And it will go back to Xavier, so they force the turnover here.
Those are the things that they need to have happen. They've got to turn up the pressure, and you heard Coach Lilly talk a little bit about it. They just expected that press to work, and maybe they didn't get the things done. They weren't ready for their quickness, and they need to be ready to slap on that pressure and create some turnovers. That's how they've won ball games this season, is have that offense turn in, or excuse me, that defense turn into offense.
Brooklyn Stanley will pick up the foul here. That's going to be the first team foul of the late half for Stanley. That's also her first. So Beyer in the paint. Steger's shot not there. Rebound to LaFleur. Well, caught up in the trap in backcourt, and it's going to be called for a travel. Boy, Xavier's starting to crank it up here.
That's where, you know, you can light that fire defensively, and then that will roll over into the offense. They've missed some point-blank shots, and they've got to start knocking some of those down.
Mader going to step on the sideline. Right in front of the bench.
Mies with a really good defense just pushed her up against the sideline.
Damke out ahead. This is Newberg.
Newberg just got herself under control. And again, I want to credit Demke. She's the one that's starting things in the backcourt, getting the ball up ahead of the defense.
That's going to be off of the foot of Heelan. It's going to stay with Xavier. They're going to go to the bench here. Three players in, as coming in is Lexi Turner along with Kyla Mason. And also out onto the floor is Riley Yonker. Kyla Mason leads this team in scoring and has yet to get a bucket here in the game.
Hasn't had a whole lot of touches even.
Vandell will set her feet. And the rebound. Going to be out of bounds. Last touch by Xavier. And the press is on.
In the first quarter.
Vandell with a steal and bucket.
Well, that's what she can do. That's the length and the quick hands and the anticipation and reading. And that's why she's so good at the top of this zone.
And she's got teammates to help her out on the backside. Take a look at the steal and score here.
Just turns around, had her back to the inbounder, then quickly turns around, read and react, gets a quick two. And then they sped up Heelan and got another turnover.
Still a 7-point game. This is going to be turned over. The Crusaders off the track. Peck out ahead. The layup, not there. Boy, it is all-out effort for these two teams.
It's become a track meet, and the one thing that you need to do is be strong with the basketball on both sides, because both of these defenses starting to reach, starting to grab, trying to swat at the ball, and you have to protect that basketball when it is in your hands.
So at the line with Riley Yonker. And she's going to get her sixth free throw attempt here in this game. Lexi Beyer back into the contest. She'll come in for Mater. She Yonker's numbers today. And it's going to be tracked down by Vandell. Could be a big possession here for Xavier.
That is a big offensive rebound, and that's one where, as a coach, you're scratching your head. How did you give up an offensive rebound on a free throw and three chances in that possession, two after the missed free throw? And they had Yonker posting up big, calling for the basketball, and they didn't get it to her.
Yeah, that was 6 foot against 5'3", and they missed the opportunity. Or could not enter the ball. Heelan trying to attack here. Mees can't get at the ball. Yonker with another rebound.
You know, you have to throw over the top of this zone. That allows the defense to get in position. It's a higher, slower pass, and you can't move it as quickly to get them out of position.
We can hear the Xavier fans yelling, "Find Yonker."
She's wide open. Again, I mean, she has got the height advantage, as you had said, and they have not been able to get it to her.
This is going to stay with Xavier.
You know, maybe this is a situation where if you're Yonker, you go to your teammates and say, "Get me the ball. I have somebody that's 4 or 5 inches shorter than me, and I can take it to the hoop."
Emma Arnold will come back into the game. She'll check in for Lexi Turner. Also back into the game is Brooklyn Stanley here for the Crusaders. She'll be at the top of that 1-3-1 zone. Here's Vandell. It's rejected. And it's going to be picked up by Mees, who blocked the shot. Out ahead to Stanley.
Well, that would have been a big layup. What a save in the backcourt to just get it into the front court. Even be able to try for that layup.
Boy, the active hands by Heelan. And one! Whoa! Kyla Mason!
Mason was down there, but you're going to see Yonker down there. Two players right there together posting up. How she got that to go. Her back was almost to the basket, able to find an angle to get it off the glass. But got to have a little bit more separation, a little bit more spacing, but that's two people picking on Maddie Demke down below.
See if this gets Mason going. A three-point play makes it a three-point game here with 2:26 to go in the third quarter, and a timeout going to be taken here by Heelan. They'll have three remaining. Let's go to the Xavier huddle.
Am I right? Quit leaking up. It's not your job. You got the cutter. Stay back in the middle of the floor. If they throw it on the sideline, we're going to squeeze them. Not you. Whoever's got the half court, your job is not to trap. Your job is to just stay back and take the cutter up the gut. That's not you. Your job is to trap. You only got one job. You guys understand what I'm saying?
Look at guys inside. The line is wide open. Every time. That's fine. Let's go. Way to keep it. Hey, finish, Skylar. We got this. Heads up. Let's go.
Oh, 16 teams Coach Lilly has guided here to the state tournament. And he's trying to hit all the buttons here, right?
He is, and he is very succinct with his message, wanting his players to understand how he wants them to move defensively. You're to trap, you're to funnel her to the sidelines. You understand what I'm saying? They do. They listen to him and they execute things of what he asks them to do.
Notice how it was all about defense with his team down as Mason deflects the ball. And it's just off the rim, and going to the line is going to be Emma Arnold.
Talk about somebody that all of a sudden it's gotten a wake-up call, and that's Mason, was able to hit a big bucket. Kind of got her going, and you had mentioned that. You said, let's see if that'll get her going, and she has started to do it defensively.
Demke picks up her third, the team's fourth against Heelan. At the line here with Emma Arnold, a 25% free throw shooter this season. And gets one out of two. It's a two-point game with 2:21 to go in the third quarter. Big quarter here so far by Xavier, as they put 10 points up on the board, and they've held Heelan to just five. Looking to drive it is Peck. And a foul called on the shot, and she'll go to the line to shoot two.
Peck putting it on the floor, trying to sneak through the defense. Went up strong. A little contact knocks her to the floor. And again, I'm going to mention her performance in the semifinal round. 17 points. And that way, I mean, they were a big 17 points. When they needed a big three-point shot, she was able to step up and knock them down.
81% free throw shooter this season. This is the first. That foul, by the way, against Emma Arnold, her first, the team's third against Xavier. So Peck, the second one. That's what we're used to seeing out of Lauren Peck. She's just an all-out scorer, but held to just a free throw today, Laura.
And both of these teams have really been able to navigate defensively and slow down some of the key scorers. And you could see Mason there taking it to the hoop, trying to connect, but I have to say that Heelan was able to shut down the two big scorers for Xavier early on in the first half. Now they're starting to come to life.
Stanley had her foot on the baseline.
Good drive and great timing with that block of Arnold.
Vandell will come back into the game. She'll be at the point. Now the Crusaders switch it up a little bit here, Laura. A little man-to-man.
A little different look. See if it confuses Xavier at all.
Vandell gets the bucket.
Boy, when she gets inside, she is so strong with the ball, keeps it up away from the defenders.
And a nice steal by Mader. The three, got it!
Huge, huge bucket steal. The tide is starting to turn, and the defense is doing it for Xavier.
First lead of the late half, first time they've led since the first quarter, and right away, the answer by Newberg.
Nobody came out to guard her, and she's been hot all game long. You got to know who is out there and make sure you're adjusting your defense, and she calmly picked it up and knocked it down.
Yonker goes inside to Mason, and she's fouled. Jada Newberg, who just hit that three for Heelan in double figures with 10. It's a one-point game with 38 seconds to play here in the third quarter. It's the Class 4A state championship, and both teams are going at it right now. About what we expected. Here's Mason.
It is. I think this game got off to a slow start on both sides. Both teams really trying to figure out what they needed to do on offense against the opponent's defense.
And the second one rolls in and out. We'll remain tied at 33. 35 seconds to go. Let's see if Heelan holds for one. They look to attack. Now looking to drive it as Mies. They kick it out to the corner. Berzel, who had the hot hand in the first half, then has yet to score here in the second. As now Mies looks to hold for one. 15 on the game clock. Quarter winding down here. Newberg, tightly guarded by Mason. Now to Peck, down to 5-4. Here's Peck. Floater, not there. Rebound, put back at the horn, left short. What a third quarter for Xavier. They have battled their way back, and Heelan able to come up with the answer with a three ball here late in the third quarter. As you see, Xavier able to use their defense here, Laura, to get things done.
Well, you try to dribble through that pressure, and those hands are swatting it. The ball, every time you're trying to get through there, you get the steal and the big three, but calmly come back down the floor, and Newberg hits another big three with the answer.
So these two teams, we mentioned it earlier, West Coast against an Eastern Iowa team. As we take a look at our state map, always great to see here at the state tournament. And of course you see Bishop Heelan in Sioux City, Woodbury County. That had to go 198 miles to get here. For Xavier and Cedar Rapids, well, 117 miles to get here from Eastern Iowa to Wells Fargo Arena, and what a trip for both. And what a 4A championship we've got here, tied at 33.
Yeah, and here in the third quarter, the game has really picked up in intensity, and it's a game that we thought we were gonna have. These defenses are going at one another, and it's gonna be very hard to score here in the fourth quarter. So again, we talked about it at the beginning of the game. Defense wins championships. It's gonna win this one here tonight.
Well, buckle up. Should be a wild 8 minutes here. 33-33, Xavier and Heelan on Iowa PBS, the first of three state championships today. Xavier battling their way back as Heelan led for 13 minutes in this game. Their largest lead was at 9. Xavier did have a 7-point lead early on that the Crusaders were able to erase. Now the drive and finish and count the bucket. Jada Newberg.
A little miscue on offense. Newberg sizes it up, the step through, able to draw the foul on Mader and convert the shot. That is a big start for the Crusaders here in the fourth quarter.
And the free throw able to be knocked down by Newberg. What a start for Heelan. Vandell in backcourt will give way to Byer. Byer drives it in, and a foul gonna be called as it was contact.
Mies was manning the baseline, was the one, the protector of the paint. She stood up straight and tall and was able to draw the charge.
It's going to be Byers' first foul. Each team with 5 fouls. Now the steal. Vandell, fake the 3, baseline.
Good read, good ball fake after the steal. Gets the defense out of position and then sees the defense rotating out and pulls up and knocks down the mid-range jumper for a big bucket.
Stanley, back out to Demke. Heelan resets. and they enter it to the block. Knees a shot not there, but what a battle to get the rebound, but it's going to be turned over. It'll go back to Xavier.
The pass, the ball fake, get that defense to commit. They rotate over. Vandell sees it and pulls up and knocks it home.
What a great young player. Again, just a freshman. Plays a lot of volleyball. Was a part of their winning team this last season. Averages about 100 shots a day, she says, out on her court. Very steady. Here's Beyer for three. Got it! We're tied. No, Xavier takes the lead here at 38-36. Beyer with her second triple of the game. And now a turnover by Heelan. Xavier will get it back.
Beyer knocks down the big three. Good dribble penetration, kicking it out, nothing but net, and then she gets back defensively and causes the turnover.
Looks like Heelan, Laura's gonna settle back to that 1-3-1 zone.
That's their bread and butter. That's what's gotten them here, and that's what they're confident in. But all of a sudden, Xavier's starting to figure out how to navigate through this zone, and now they're gonna be patient in what they do.
Here's Beyer for three again. Got it! Whoa!
Oh, I'm telling you what, when it's a wake-up call, it's a wake-up call, and Beyer hit one early, has hit two big ones here.
And a steal by Xavier, then a foul by Stanley. That'll be the sixth team foul on Heelan.
And that's a deep three. That was back on that second line, towing it up. And she is a player, that's her game. She's a three-point shooter. She's gonna take that game on Dolores and play next year, and they're gonna get a good one.
Timeout gonna be taken here by Bishop Heelan. 5:55 to play in the game. Let's hear what the Crusaders are gonna talk over here during this timeout.
Hey, listen. Maddie, you're going to the corner. Kinley, you're going to the corner. On a made basket, Jocelyn, you can move, okay? You get it in, you gotta get out of there, okay?
There's nowhere to go if she gets it in.
What?
I don't have anywhere to go.
Brooklyn's coming back, okay?
Even if I pass it there, I can't. It's not open.
We haven't done this yet.
I tried to throw it there and they got a layup.
No.
That was a different setup.
The last thing
their girl
was taking it out. You and Maddie both broke to the corners.
This is wide open.
Jocelyn's
gonna go. Brooklyn, you don't be afraid to go get a handoff and then take off with it.
Hey, stick together no matter what out there. Stick together. Our turn to make a run right now.
Here we go. 1, 2, 3.
41-36, Xavier with the lead. Heelan taking that timeout. They have one timeout remaining now. Possession arrow is in favor of Heelan.
Well, only having that one timeout could be a problem down the stretch. You may need that, but you've needed to use them throughout the game, and you could hear in that huddle a lot of intensity, a lot of thoughts going through everybody's head. And they need to be able to work through that to be able to stay close in this ball game and see if they can climb back in.
Unbound, the statistics page for Iowa high school basketball and other sports. They are ranked number one on bound, but I tell you what, number six on those power rankings is looking pretty good now in Xavier as they're able to get the bucket and they extend their lead now to seven.
So they changed it up a little bit. They pressured on the inbound pass, but then they backed off.
This is Bees. Can't get it. And the rebound is gonna somehow come down to Beyer of Xavier. Vandell, the wraparound pass. Here's Mason. And opportunity here for Mees and Heelan.
Couple of great opportunities, and what a great take by Mees, taking it right at the defender.
The junior able to get the bucket, now with eight. And you heard her in the huddle. talking things over with Coach Koolstra. But you can tell she's the floor general out on the floor and wanted that last bucket in a bad way. Now the dump down. How about that? A quick two by Riley Yonker, her second field goal of the game. Yonker now in double figures with 11.
Boy, that was so well executed. Little mid, high, low.
And we had a foul on the inbounds pass. A hold is called against Xavier. So each team with 16 fouls. And in backcourt with Stanley.
You got to get some help. You've got to have a teammate come to the middle. That's where you can break pressure when you get somebody to the middle. The double team just continually closed in. You've got to get a teammate breaking back so you can get rid of that ball.
Now they look to break it with Mies across the half court line. Out into the corner, Peck. Can't get it, Mies with the rebound. Put back, yes.
She has come up big in this ball game and went up amongst a lot of outstretched arms and navigated her way through to that basket.
5-point game, 3:50 to play. This jumper off the mark. It's going to be deflected out on Heelan as Lexi Turner was able to get that rebound.
You can see the rebound and then the strong put back by Meese. She had to split a couple of defenders. That's a great inbound play. Yonker with the height advantage. She's been asking to get the ball in that spot all game long.
Yonker able to find her. And the lead back to 7. Peck, the reversal. Here's a 3 at the top. And the rebound to Xavier. And a timeout going to be taken here by the Saints. 3:22 to play. Xavier leads it by 7. They've erased a 9-point deficit here in the second half. As Yonker's able to get the quick bucket here.
Just stayed right there in the block and got an easy bucket.
Let's hear what Tom Lilly has to say.
Huh?
This team's back in.
Under Lexi.
Who's got 15?
Guys, we're going to try shooting triples.
You got to switch. Switch the screens out on the three-point line.
Keep looking for Riley.
All right, we're good. Sit down and take a chill.
Relax, it's 90 seconds.
Make sure we're communicating out there. Talk loud, you gotta talk loud. Play with poise, okay? You gotta be strong with the ball because they're gonna be reaching and slapping. All right, next one's gonna be foul shooting. All right, here we go.
Let's go, guys.
Love it. I take a chill. We got 90 seconds here. But then some wise words. Take care of the ball. Be strong with the ball. They're going to be reaching. They're going to be slapping. Be strong with it. And just have some fun out there. And that's exactly. He's having fun. And I know his players are having fun.
Well, he said, told us that they've been playing state tournament-like games for much of the second half of the season in the Mississippi Valley Conference, and which has prepared them for the state tournament run. They lead it by 7 to Xavier. Here's a good look at Mason, and she'll go to the line to shoot 2. Hey, why don't we have a moment, Laura? I just want to say, you know, it's been a great week. You know, mixing nostalgia with new information. You know, all of us here at Iowa PBS were able to draw information from everywhere, but really want to thank the Sioux City Journal and also the Cedar Rapids Gazette for their outstanding coverage of high school athletics throughout the entire year. And it's really culminated. Jeff Linder at the Gazette does a terrific job. The stories, the background. 9-point lead now for Xavier.
And Jeff Linder sitting right behind us, furiously typing away to get another great story out for everybody to read.
Xavier going for their 5th state championship. Trying to cut it. Back door was Demke. Still ends up with the ball. Heelan, gonna have to try to hurry here. Who do you go to?
Well, I think that's the player that you could go to, Brooklyn Stanley. She's had a pretty good tournament so far and has been kind of quiet in this ball game, but if you need some points in a hurry, that's who you go to.
Fell to just 2 points. And a five count can be called on Fandel.
You know, you want to take time off the clock, but you've got to try to advance it. And you want to get it, and you can do that by passing.
Nine-point lead here. Big possession for Heelan. And the Crusaders come up empty.
We just have not been able to get the angle on those looks as they drive into the defense. Not getting those shoulders square so they can get a good look at the hoop and the backboard.
And to the line with Mary Kate Mader. Senior with 9 points today. Can't get the free throw to go down. And now the rebound by Mies. She's going to attack. And lost the grip. And it will be turned over.
Right idea, just got a little ahead of herself. They need points in a hurry. And she got down there in a hurry, just couldn't gather herself to get the shot up.
So if you're Xavier, I mean, 150 to play, they've been go, go, go. Do you run clock here?
You run a little clock, you be patient, and make them come out. Now they're picking up, it looks like man-to-man. And you have to do that because you need to either slow the clock down or get a steal if you can, or stop the clock and put them on the line.
And I can just hear in some of the living rooms where you're watching these games today, that's why they need a shot clock. It's coming next year, 35-second shot clock.
And I think much needed. I think it's certainly an addition to the high school game that is needed. A lot of these players go on and play in college, and they play with a shot clock.
Mader able to knock down the first free throw, making it a 10-point game. What a turnaround in this one.
Big, it started about midway through the third quarter where Xavier started getting their feet underneath them, their legs underneath them, and they got back to playing the principles that got them here.
Here's Mies left alone. And Demke with the rebound. Kick out. Here's Peck.
The shots that were falling the other day just are not falling for Peck here in this fourth quarter.
Been corrected also on your smartphones that you may be watching on.
And your iPads and every other medium that we have.
It's all covered here on Iowa PBS, and Xavier trying to salt this one away. 35 seconds to play, an 11-point lead, and they're sensing the title as Peck will pick up the foul here.
Little smile on Mary Kate Mader's face as she's passing the ball around the top, knowing that they will soon have that trophy in their hands.
And the free throw made. 6 losses this season for Xavier. As you feel for the Crusaders. I mean, what a run.
You know, and they're celebrating 50 years of basketball at their school. They have the throwback warm-up tops that they have as a nod to the beginning of basketball at Heelan. And it's a great, great season for this Bishop Heelan team.
14-point lead. Each team going to try to clean out their bench. Get an opportunity to play in the state championship game. As Xavier burned the timeout there. or Heelan did, excuse me. They have no timeouts remaining, but 21.5 seconds to play, and what a 4A championship game we've had here. Midway through the third quarter, you called it. It was the turning point, the tipping point for Xavier to come back and win this.
And I can't point to one thing of what happened. It just all of a sudden, things started going. There's a couple of big threes by Beyer that she knocked down that kind of maybe flipped the switch for them.
Well, and the scoring got going out of their big three, Fandale, Beyer, and then, of course, Mason. And Mason will finish the game with 8, Fandale with 9. 13 points scored today for the Saints, and Riley Yonker, a huge game for her. As Bishop Heelan will hold the ball here. Coming up, we've got the all-tournament team to be announced, plus the trophy presentation. This one gonna be deflected away. Xavier will pick it up, a heave at the horn, and that is it. The Xavier Saints are your 4A champions. Well deserved for Xavier. You think about the tournament trail that they had to take to get here in Class 4A, beating Central DeWitt in the opener by 7, a triple overtime win against Dallas Center Grimes, and now outlasting Bishop Heelan by 14 in the title game.
What a really great second half by Xavier. They turned things around, they figured it out. Made some adjustments at halftime, and I'm going to tell you what, I think Riley Yonker might have taken the biggest charge of her life in the celebration huddle as she got knocked to the ground as they were all jumping up and down and huddling around. But what excitement over there, and what a great comeback for Coach Lilly.
So now we await the announcement of the all-tournament team. Let's turn it over to PA announcer Tim Fitzpatrick.
Class 4A all-tournament team. Presenting the awards is Brent Johnson, president of the Iowa Farm Bureau. Joining him are members of the IGHSAU Board of Directors, Shan Sievert, Greg Defoe, Travis Fleschner, Jennifer Donalds, Russ Adams, and Jim Beamer. Here is your Class 4A all-tournament team. From Xavier, Kyla Mason. From Bishop Heelan, Jada Newberg. From Glenwood, Abby Hughes. From Dallas Center Grimes, Emma Miner. From Bishop Heelan, Brooklyn Stanley. And your 4A All-Tournament team captain, from Xavier, Libby Fandale.
That is a freshman who is your all-tournament team captain.
And well-deserving, and that's a really good group of young ladies. Kyla Mason had a really nice game, came alive in the second half. And Libby Fandale as the all-tournament captain.
I believe it's the second freshman ever are in the state tournament. Stokes, yet last night of Estherville Lincoln Central, the all-tournament team captain. Now time for the trophy presentation.
Class 4A runner-up, the Bishop Heelan Crusaders and head coach Darren Koolstra. And fans, let's hear it for your 2022 Class 4A champion, the Xavier Saints and head coach Tom Lilly.
Xavier earned it all the way to be your 4A champion.
Yeah, it was kind of a game of two halves, and Xavier came out in the second half and really flipped the switch, got things going, got their defense going, and racked up some points, and they are a state champion.
Let's go to Paul Yeager, who is standing by.
Great job, BJ and Laura. Thank you very much. If math serves me, Xavier down at one point, 29-20, went on a 34-11 run to close out the game and become champions in Class 4A from the 4 seed in the class. So 4 is wild. All right, that's going to do it for our game one of this triple header here on Iowa PBS Sports. But we are just getting started. We will be back. We've got more interviews, features, and basketball. Three trophies down, two more to go. Tip-off of the 2A championship is coming up on statewide Iowa PBS.
Funding provided by
you work hard to feed them well. That's why at Fairway, we're committed to our foundation of personalized service while treating our customers like family and valuing our employees. Fairway Meat and Grocery, that's what we're all about.
By Muskell Lighting, the sports lighting specialists, providing lighting systems for you, your project, and your community.
Small businesses are the backbone of Iowa's communities, and they are backed by Iowa banks. With advice, loans, and financial services, banks across Iowa are committed to showing small businesses the way to a stronger tomorrow. Learn more at iowabankers.com.